All right, I'm gonna keep it real with you. 81% of shoppers research their product online before purchasing, and 40% of those start with a Google search, and 100% of those Google searches use keywords to help determine if your website should appear on the results page. So what are you doing if you're not working keywords into your strategy? You know what I'm saying? What's up, it's Jamal. Welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm gonna demonstrate the 7 easy steps for discovering the right keywords for your business, so that customers can have an easy time discovering your business online. We also have a free resource in the description that will help you perfectly execute on everything we talk about today. And while you're down there, you might as well subscribe to the channel and click that notification bell. Keywords are one of the fundamental building blocks of SEO. They're words or short phrases that help search engines match the content on your website with users looking for the products or services that you offer. Keywords live in various places on your website, including titles, body text, URLs, and in the metadata that lives on the back end. Search engine bots are constantly indexing sites across the internet, recording the keywords you use, and then cross-referencing them with the user's search terms when generating the results for each search. Without the right keywords in the right places, it's incredibly difficult for search engines to know that your site contains the content users are looking for. Keywords are far from the only factor used by search engines to determine results. A 2017 study of over 600,000 websites concluded that keywords occupy 5 of the top 15 factors used by the Google algorithm to determine page ranking. That's why you need to be constantly creating new content that utilizes up-to-date keywords that reflect what users are looking for. So I'm gonna teach you the 7-step process for brainstorming and vetting keywords that will get eyes on your site. And if you wanna use these keywords to maximum effect, be sure to download our free SEO starter pack from the description below. So when researching keywords, you wanna start by making a list of relevant topics for your business. These aren't keywords yet, but rather general topics that are connected to your products or services. For example, let's imagine that your company makes fitness apps for smartphones. Start by making a list of top-level topics based on fitness. Things like workouts, nutrition, health benefits, and so on. You wanna have between 5 to 10 topic pillars, depending on your industry. Next, take a look at each topic and fill those buckets with possible keywords. For workouts, you could include specifics like ab workouts, shoulder workouts, arm workouts, workouts to get swole and big like Jamal. I'm sorry. And other topics people search for like 10-minute workouts or at-home workouts. Pro tip, when you run out of ideas off the top of your head, you can start typing potential keywords into Google and see what comes up in the autocomplete.
I can't find this client info.
Have you heard of HubSpot? HubSpot is a CRM platform, so it shares its data across every application. Every team can stay aligned. No out-of-sync spreadsheets or dueling databases. HubSpot, grow better.
Autocomplete is honestly kind of like a cheat code into seeing what people around the web are searching for and what keywords they're using to look something up. Type workouts into Google and you'll see additional ideas for keywords like workouts to lose belly fat and workouts for beginners. Next, select one of those autocomplete keywords, then scroll down to the related searches at the bottom of the results page. You can keep going down the rabbit hole for each keyword you come up with, gathering more and more possibilities as you go. Kind of like the rabbit in Alice in Wonderland, you know, you just keep going down until you end up at a tea party. A tea party where all the guests are your favorite keywords. Delightful. Eventually, you'll have dozens, if not hundreds, of keywords in your potential list. The challenge is now determining which keywords you could potentially rank for. After all, if workouts to lose belly fat is so popular that it shows up in Google's autocomplete, it also means that there are probably already a lot of sites trying to answer that question. The best keywords are the ones with a high search volume but low competition for ranking. To determine which keywords qualify, it's time to use a keywords research tool. There are dozens of popular tools out there, but let's focus on Google's own keyword ideas tool. First, let's test out workouts to lose belly fat. You'll see that there's a search volume of 10 to 100K, but a medium competition score. If you're already an established brand with a good online presence, ranking for a medium competition keyword might be possible. But if you're just starting out, you probably don't have the site authority to be a contender. But that doesn't mean you should give up hope. I don't want to see you give up. Look below the results, and Google gives you a long list of additional keywords to consider. You can filter to just show the low competition results and discover that there are recommendations like 3 best exercises to lose belly fat after 50 that have low competition and a respectable 1K to 10K monthly search volume. One result, exercises for love handles, even has an impressive 10K to 100K MSV, low competition, and a 900% 3-month increase, meaning that it's a trending keyword that you'll probably want to get on right away. Keep repeating this process, removing difficult keywords and adding new opportunities until you have a manageable list of potential keywords to use in your online content. In the end, you want to have a blend of short tail keywords, which are 1 to 2 words, with higher MSV and tougher competition, and long tail keywords, which are 3 to 6 words long and have a lower search volume, but are easier to rank for. And as you start ranking for those long tail keywords, all right, Google will start raising your authority, making it easier for you to rank for tougher keywords. You just need some wins under your belt. In fact, let's look at some other places where you can get quick wins with keyword research. Now that you have your vetted keyword list, check the search results page for each one and see if there are any Google special features, like a paragraph snippet or a list. You'll see that this one in particular has an image pack on the top. So make a note to create content using the keyword that is heavy on photos or infographics in the hope that some of these images might appear in the pack. You can also take a look at the keywords your competitors rank for. For example, Freeletics is a popular workout app. Use Google's keyword tool to analyze freeletics.com and you'll see that Jumping Jack Muscles Worked is trending with good search volume and low difficulty. Why should Freeletics get all the Google traffic for Jumping Jack Muscles Worked? It's a little selfish of them, I must say. Just make sure that whatever keywords you get from the competition actually applies to your brand. Training Progressive Overload has all the right metrics, but if your app doesn't offer those type of workouts, then users who come to you looking for it will quickly leave your site. And that's kind of an L, not gonna lie. Because that can actually hurt other SEO metrics like retention and damage your site's credibility in the eyes of Google. Because when it comes to SEO, keywords matter, but there are always other factors to consider. To learn more about the process of finding keywords, you can find a link to a free HubSpot Academy lesson on the subject in the description. And if you want to learn more about keyword tools, check out our video interview with Sam O from Ahrefs. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to go tank my own company's SEO so that your company can rank ahead of it. That's a sacrifice that I'm willing to make because I want to see you succeed. Until then, I'll see you next time. Potential keywords to use in your online content to rank for hard. Earthquake. All right.